Wednesday of the fourth week of Lent. Our Mass presider for today is Reverend Father Ronald Ray Espartinas, SVD, Vice Rector of the Shrine. Our celebration will now begin. Please rise.
In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to the Shrine. The readings for today are very reassuring. The first reading says, God says to all of us, He will never forget you. He will help you. He will answer you. And He will keep you. In the Gospel, Jesus also promises, just as the Father gives life, so also Him, so those who come to Jesus will find life. So in this Mass, we surrender ourselves to the Lord, surrender our anxieties, our worries, our concerns and needs, surrender our woundedness and future. The Lord will never forget us. And so for us to worthily offer ourselves in this celebration, let us first recall our sins and ask God for His pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who reward the merits of the just and offer pardon to sinners who do penance, have mercy, we pray, on those who call upon you, that the admission of our guilt may serve to obtain your pardon for our sins. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, in a time of favor, I answer you. On the day of salvation, I help you, and I have kept you and given you as a covenant to the people to restore the land and allot the desolate heritages, saying to the prisoners, come out. To those in darkness, show yourselves. Along the ways they shall find pasture. On every bare height shall their pastures be. They shall not hunger or thirst, nor shall the scorching wind and the sun strike them. For he who pities them leads them and guides them beside springs of water. I will cut a road through all my mountains and make my highways level. See, Some shall come from afar, others from the north and from the west, and some from the land of Zion. Sing out, O heavens, and rejoice, O earth. Break forth into song, you mountains, for the Lord comforts his people and shows mercy to his afflicted. But Zion said, the Lord has forsaken me. My Lord has forgotten me. Can a mother forget her infant, be without tenderness for the child of her womb? Even should she forget, I will never forget you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
The Lord is faithful in all his words and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth.
The Lord is gracious and merciful. Please rise as and we honor the Holy Gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus answered the Jews, "My Father is at work until now, so I am at work." For this reason, they tried all the more to kill him, because he not only broke the Sabbath, but he also called God his own Father, making himself equal to God. Jesus answered and said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, the Son cannot do anything on his own, but only what he sees the Father doing. For what he does, the Son will do also. For the Father loves the Son and shows him everything that he himself does. And he will show him greater works than this, so that you may be amazed. For just as the Father raises the dead and gives life, so also does the Son gives life to whomever he wishes. Nor does the Father judge anyone, but he has given all judgment to the Son, so that all may honor the Son just as they honor the Father. Whoever does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent him. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life and will not come to condemnation, but has passed from death to life. Amen, amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and is now here when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so also he gave to the Son the possession of life in himself, and he gave him power to exercise judgment, because he is the Son of Man. But do not be amazed at this, because the hour is coming in which all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and will come out. Those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, but those who have done wicked deeds to the resurrection of condemnation. I cannot do anything on my own. I judge as I hear, and my judgment is just, because I do not seek my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Hindi ko kayo kakalimutan kahit sandali. Yan po ang pangako ng Diyos sa unang pagbasa. Hindi kanya kakalimutan, hindi kanya pababayaan. Sana kung minsan isang araw matagpuan po ninyo iyong sarili nang kayo ay nababalot ng takot, nerbiyos, o ang inyong mga kaisipan ay may mga mabibigat na dinadala dahil sa gitna ng maraming problema, huwag niyo pong kakalimutan ang ipinangako ng Diyos sa ating lahat. Hindi kanya kakalimutan kahit sandali, not even a second. Kaya sana you say this prayer in silence when your mind and heart is troubled. In the depth of your heart, you say, hindi ako kakalimutan ng Panginoon. Hindi niya ako pababayaan. He will come to help. He will come to answer. He came to keep us. Sabi sa gospel, whoever recognize the Father, the Son will bring him from death to life, from darkness to light. Itong mga katagang ito ay naging maliwanag po sa akin minsan nang naka-attend ako ng isang burial ng isang old mother. Yung kanyang mga anak na marami nagkwento sa akin. Sabi nila, lubos sila nagpapasalamat sa Panginoong Diyos at sa kanilang nanay. Butihing nanay. Kasi po yung kanilang nanay, maagang na byuda at madami sang katutak silang mga anak. Ngayon, sa dusa at sakit, ang nanay daw nila, ang laging sinasabi sa kanila, halos araw-araw, huwag kayong mabahala sapagkat ang Diyos ay hindi nakakalimot. Ang Diyos ay hindi nagpapabaya. And that was the words the mother kept on telling to the children. So, nagpasalamat yung mga anak kasi sabi niya, Father, na itanim sa amin ang kahalagahan ng manalig sa Diyos. And you know what faith brought to their life? Anong nagawa ng faith sa kanila? Dahil sa faith nila sa isa't isa, nagtulungan sila. Nagtulungan sila. Then, they build one another. Naging mabunga yung kanilang samahan, nagtulungan, they help one another, they build one another. And you call this miracle of faith. Even there is crisis, ang isang tao may panampalataya will see the situation differently. Hindi ito na ang trials and pain, hindi hadlang, but a challenge. Kung meron kang faith sa iyong puso, you will have more motivation. God will motivate you to move forward. It's called grace. While some families, pag dumadaan sa bankruptcy ng business, pag merong nagkasakit ang isang wife, ang isang anak, ang iba, kung walang faith, humihina ang kalooban, na normal naman talaga. Initially, pag may pinadaan ang family na problema, totoo talaga, we find ourselves disappointment, discouraging. Pero kung may faith ka, it will help you see beyond the situation. But some people do not turn to God. Kaya ang iba, to escape the problem, to escape bitterness, they turn to alcohol, they turn to drugs, they turn to sexual pleasure just to release the pain and bitterness. Kaya ang iba, pag may problema yung mga anak, maaga nag-aasawa tuloy. And sometimes it led to breakup of the family. I hope you can register and follow me. Kaya nga, ang imbitasyon sa mga pagbasa ngayon, allow God to lead you to pass from darkness to light, from death to life, and only Jesus can bring you there. Faith in God will help you go beyond, kasi dadali kayo ng Panginoong Diyos, kasi hindi siya nakakalimot. And see that better days are ahead. Sana sa mga nanay nakikinig dito sa akin, nasa online, tularan po natin yung nanay na kinakwento ko sa gitna ng problema, sa mga lolo nandyan, mga lola, sa mga tatay, sa mga elder, sa mga tiya. Kung may mapamangkin kayo when the situation is so tough, kindly be the light of the house. Tell these people, your children, your husband, your wife, hindi makakalimot ang Diyos. Hindi niyo tayo papabayaan. Pangalawa naman, a second point po gusto ipaabo sa inyo, to give tribute to the mothers. Yan po sabi sa first reading. Hindi ang isang nanay, hindi makakalimot na umibig sa kanyang mga anak. Sa mga nanay na nakikinig ngayon, thank you for all your sacrifices. You are nearest and closest to God's heart. Alam niyo kung bakit? Because you are giving up a lot of things to your children, for your family. Kaya nga, please appreciate yourself. Hope you find value and mission and purpose for being a mother. Kung meron mo na kayong ipagpasalamat sa Diyos, ipasalamat nyo muna na una, pinanganak kayo at naging kayong babae. Because naging babae kayo, nagkaroon kayong potentials to become a mother, a beautiful vocation. Kaya sa mga anak din nakikinig po ngayon sa akin dito, please be thankful to your mother. And just in case yung mga nanay ninyo cause you pain and hurt in the past, please be very forgiving and understanding. No one is perfect. Ang mga nanay talaga, they are fighting many battles. May sarili din silang past woundedness. May sarili din silang private issue. Insecurities, takot, past woundedness. Pero kahit alam nila kailangan bigyan pansin ito at asakyaso na kanilang sarili, they cannot give themselves much time. Kasi kailangan muna unahin nila kanilang pamilya, mga anak, for their own good. Kaya nga later, usually, later na lang nila mabibigyan pa sila kanilang sarili. Kaya nga sa mga anak, sa mga asawa nandito, please be very careful with your words to your mother, your wife. I would like to close this homily sa kwento po ng movie na ginanapan ni Lorna Tolentino at ni Albert Martinez. 2001, Abakada, Inay. Bakit Abakada? Kasi si Lorna Tolentino doon, mangmang, di marunong magbasa. Alam niyo nung kwento noon, mangmang siya kasi I think he did not even finish grade 1. May tatlo siyang anak. Ang asawa niya doon si Albert Martinez. Kaya nga ang problema ni Lorna doon, nagpapaturo pa siya sa kanyang anak na eldest paano magsulat. Kaya yung si Albert Martinez, minsan binibiro siya, "Oh, mangmang ka. Matalino pa sa iyong mga anak mo." Pero yung height ng movie doon, para napuno na rin si Lorna Tolentino, napatunong siya, sino kanyang i-blame sa kanyang sitwasyon? Bakit siya naging mangmang? Yung kanyang nanay. Pinutan yung kanyang nanay, kinonfront niya na kanyang nanay. Ito yung kanyang usapan. "Nay, bakit hindi mo ako pinaaral ng bata ako? Bakit mo ako pinabayaan? Pero tuloy ngayon, mangmang ako." Alam mo kasi nangyari din pala noon, na grade 1 pa lang si Lorna Tolentino, namatay yung kanyang tatay. Kung grade 1 ka, wala kang kaalam-alam that your father passed away. It will not make sense to you. But yung nanay niya, natulala, naka-breakdown. Natulala na lang. Kaya si Lorna Tolentino, napabayaan niya. Di niya naasikaso bigyan ng baon, kahit notebook, kahit yung tinelas ni Lorna Tolentino that time, punit-punit na. Kaya one time, pauwi si Lorna Tolentino as a grade 1 student, bumaha pa, yung kanyang tsinelas, nalubog sa baha. Doon siya pinanginaan ng kalooban. Nag-decide siya, "Di na ako mag-aaral. Wala namang nanay na tumutulong." Tapos sabi ni Lorna Tolentino sa nanay niya, "Nay, bakit hindi mo pinaaral?" Itong sagot ng nanay, "Eh, pasensya na anak. Nang panahon na iyon, nawala ako sa sarili ko. at sabi mo rin noon, ayaw mo na mag-aral. Sabi ni Lord, dapat nanay, pinagalitan mo ako. Dapat kinaladkadkad mo papuntang eskwelahan. Pinilit mo dapat ako mag-aral. Pero anyway, to cut the story short, nagsorry yung nanay, pasensya anak at napabayaan kita. Pero ang point po ng movie ganito, kahit mangmang man si Lauren Tilintino, yung mga anak niyang tatlo, napalaki niya mabuting tao na may magandang pag-uugali. Mga kapatid, sa mga anak nandito, sa mga asawa nakikinig, sa mga nanay minsan, sa loob ng pamilya, you don't understand one another. Sometimes that's the reason why you quarrel. Sometimes you don't know the reason why are you quarreling. It's just because bawat isa may pinagdaanan pala, fighting their own battle, passing from darkness to light, passing from death to light in Jesus. Kaya nga, in this, the Word of God tells you, the Father sent the Son to bring you, to pass, to cross over your family from darkness to light. Kaya nga, paala din po sa mga tatay, nanay, mga anak, help one another that you can cross from woundedness to healing. Help one another that you can cross, pass from death to life as a family. At mangyari lamang ito if you be extra understanding to one another, extra patience, extra forgiving, and sana yung salita na lumalabas sa bunganga natin will become therapeutic. You fill up the emptiness of one another. May your words be healing the missing pieces of one another. And this is what God is doing with us through and to. Even you forget Him, He will never forget you. We rise. As we bring our petitions before the altar of God, let us ask for the strength and faith to abide by His will. For every prayer, your response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may guide her members in the path of goodness and bring them to God's love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may turn away from sin with all our hearts and be obedient to God's laws, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who are undergoing trial and persecution on account of their faith may persevere and trust in God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may follow the example given to us by Jesus and conform to the will of God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our frontline healthcare workers and other essential workers, that God may cover them with the mantle of protection, sustain them, and give them strength as they perform their respective duties. May we have enough medical provisions, healthcare facilities, and other resources to use for everyone who need cure. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may finally receive God's promise of eternal life. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In a special way, I would like to lift up to the Lord all the mass intentions offered here at the Diocesan Shrine of Jesus the Divine Word and Christ the King Mission Seminary. All this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the power of the sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the
Lord.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness, and so we glorify you with countless angels, and with one voice of praise we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Onesto Ongchoco our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by his divine teaching, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Peace to everyone. Those in the online, Facebook, YouTube channel, peace to all of you.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Manalangin tayo. May your heavenly gifts, O Lord, we pray, which you bestow as heavenly remedy on your people, not bring judgment to those who receive them, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Oratio imperata. Merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness in life. We come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and health, restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country and the whole world. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body. Strengthen in their commitment protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all, and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. We apply to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady, Health of the Sick. Saint Joseph. Saint Raphael, the Archangel. San Roque. San Lorenzo Ruiz. San Pedro Calungsod. Saint Arnold Jansen and Joseph Prainademits. Please be seated for some announcement. Our schedule of masses and other activities are as follows. Daily masses, Monday to Saturday, 6:30 a.m. and 6 p.m. Sundays at 6 a.m., 8 a.m., 10 p.m., 11:30 a.m., 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. Confession every on Saturday at 5 p.m. and on Sundays at 11 a.m. and 5 a.m. Lenten activities. Stations of the Cross is every Friday at 5 p.m. Palm Sunday will follow the regular mass schedule as shown on the screen. Schedule of the Holy Week activities is also shown on the screen and will be posted on our Facebook page and bulletin boards outside the shrine. The Fast to Feed the Child, a Lenten fundraising campaign of the Hapag-Asa Integrated Nutrition Program, whose aim is to help feed the hungry children, is calling for your support. For those who wish to help feed the hungry children, envelopes are available at the back. You may leave your envelopes at the collection boxes or drop them during the offertory. Once again, we thank you for your support. God bless you all. Reverend Father Ronnie Crisostomo, SVD, Shrine Rector. Please rise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may our Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.